You have all heard Neil Armstrong's famous words, right? When he became the first human being landed on the moon, he said, "One small step for a man and one giant leap for mankind." Well, Motorola was there to provide a radio transponder that was used to send those words to planet Earth. Let's talk more about Motorola. The company started in Chicago, Illinois as Galvin Manufacturing Corporation in 1928. The two brothers, Paul and Joseph Galvin, purchased the Stewart Battery Company's battery eliminator plants and equipment at auction for $750. The company started in a small space in a rented building. They have a working capital of 565 and 5 employees. Their first product were battery eliminators, devices that enabled a battery-powered radios to operate on household electricity. Soon, it became obsolete because of the advancement of radio technology. Soon after that, Paul decided to make a portable radio as he learned that some other radio technicians installed it set in cars. They were successful and demonstrated their products in the Radio Manufacturing Association in Atlantic, New Jersey in 1930. Paul Galvin wanted to create a catchy brand name for his car radio. He combined the word motor with the popular suffix during that time, Ola, and created Motorola. The company and the brand name itself became famous that time.
Ang susunod na programa ay rated PG. Patnubay at gabay ng magulang ay kailangan sa mga batang manonood.
Magandang hapon, Pilipinas, at welcome to Family Feud! Bago ang lahat, baka nagtataka kayo kung bakit ako ang nasa harapan nyo at hindi ang asawa kong si Dong. Pansamantala po muna siyang wala ngayong araw, pero huwag kayong mag-alala dahil ako muna ang papalit sa kanya. Ako nga pala si Marian Rivera Dantes, ang may bahay ni Dingdong Dantes, and welcome sa pinakamasayang game show ng buong mundo, Family Feud! Napakadali lang ng ating game. Ang sagot sa mga tanong ay batay sa survey ng 100 Pinoy. So, kailangan nating hulaan ng dalawang team ang pinaka-top answer ng mga kababayan natin. Ang team na makakahula ng mas mataas na score ang panalo at pwedeng mag-uwi ng 200,000 pesos! Pero bago tayo magsimula, papakilala ko muna sa inyo ang Team 1 natin. Pinapangunahan ng Team 1 na si Kathryn, Bernardo, Liza, Soberano, and Ann Curtis. Ang Team 2 naman natin ay sina Denise, Laurel, Yassi, Pressman, and Jericho, Rosales! Kaya alamin na natin kung ano ang sabi ng survey. Team Captains, Team 1, and Team 2, let's play the game. Nag-survey kami ng 100 tao and the top 5 answers are on the board. Name a company that became the leading competitors of Motorola at the time of their failure. Then, mag-start tayo kay Ann Curtis.
Apple?
Pwede!
Pwede, pwede!
Pwede, pwede!
Apple, ang sabi ng survey ay... Grabe! Napakagandang panimula niyan, no? At dahil nakuha mo ang top answer, pass or play?
Play, syempre.
Okay. Then, mag-proceed naman tayo kay Liza Soberano. Liza Soberano, name a company that became the leading competitors of Motorola at the time of their failure.
So, galing sa land of opas, Samsung!
Pwede, pwede. Pwede yun.
Samsung ang sabi ng survey ay? Pasok. Maganda yan, guys. Then, mag-proceed naman tayo kay Kathryn Bernardo. Name a company that became the leading competitors of Motorola at the time of their failure.
Vivo?
Wala ka na.
Vivo! Naku, tingnan nga natin kung meron. Ang sabi ko ay?
Oh,
sorry, Miss Kathryn. Balik tayo sa'yo. Ann Curtis. Name a company that became the leading competitors of Motorola at the time of their failure.
Lenovo?
Lenovo!
Pwede, pwede, pwede!
Meron yan!
At ang sabi ng survey ay... Pasok pa din. Napakagaling nga naman, no? Kay Liza Soberano naman, name a company that became the leading competitors of Motorola at the time of their failure.
Ito ang hindi papakabog. Pinakamatibay na cellphone, Nokia.
Nokia, pwede, Nokia, pwede. Nokia.
Wala, wala.
Nokia, pwede, ang sabi naman ng survey natin ay... Third answer pa nga.
Isa na lang.
Isa na lang, isa na lang. Win the record. Miss Kathryn Bernardo, name a company that became the leading competitors of Motorola at the time of their failure.
Grabe, nakaka-pressure.
HTC?
HTC. Ano nga ba ang kukumpleto sa survey? Ang sabi ng survey ay... At dahil nakuha nyo lahat ng top answers sa survey, mapupunta sa inyo ang 100 points!
Yay! Yay! Galing mo, Kathryn!
Now, let's move on to the second round, Team 1 and Team 2. Let's play the game. Nag-survey kami ng 100 tao and the top 5 answers are on the board. Name a strategy that Motorola used at the time they are struggling with their sales performance. Mag-start naman tayo kay Denise Laurel.
Price. Name a...
Price. Pwede, pwede.
Tingnan nga na. Wala, wala. Nauna pa sa host. Wala yan.
Ang sabi naman ng survey natin ay... Grabe naman yung mga hanap ko. At dahil ako mag up answer, first birthday. Liza Soberano. Ay, hindi pala. My gosh, nakahalo-halo na tayo. Sobrang gaganda nung lahat. Kaya si Pressman naman tayo. Name a strategy that Motorola used at the time they are struggling with their sales performance.
Please, please.
Wala, wala. Wala, wala, wala.
Please, tingnan naman natin kung may place. Ang sabi ng survey ay... Pasok pa din. Napakadal naman talaga. Eto, eto. Ang nag-iisang muse ng buong game show na to. Mr. Jericho Rosales, name a strategy that Motorola used at the time of their struggling with their sales performance.
People?
Tinatin. Ang sabi ng survey ay? So sorry, hindi gumana ang pagiging muse mo, Miss Jericho. Balik tayo kay Dennis Laurel. Name a strategy that Motorola used at the time they are struggling with their sales performance.
Product.
Pwede. Tingnan nga natin. Ayan. Ang sabi ng survey ay? Last one. At pwede nyo nang makuha 100 points at tatabla kayo sa Team 1. Yassi Pressman. Name a strategy that Motorola used at the time they are struggling with their sales performance.
Oh my God.
Wala. Sorry, Miss Yassi. Stand by. Kapag ito ay hindi pa nila nakuha, kung pwede na kayo mag-steal, okay? Prepare for your answer. Jericho Rosales, last chance na to. Name a strategy that Motorola used at the time they are struggling with their sales performance.
Promotion!
Promotion?
Wala yan.
Tingnan natin kung ito na yung magliligtas sa inyo. Survey said? At dahil nakuha nyo lahat ng top answers sa survey, mapupunta sa inyo ang 100 points. Tayo na kayo ng group 1. Grabe naman yon. Parehong grupo ang nakakuha ng parehas na puntos. Sino kaya ang mananalo at mag-uwi ng 200,000 pesos. At kung ano natin ngayon sa pagbabalik ang Family Feud.
Good morning, Angels.
Good morning, Charlie.
We'll be right back.
Hello, Moto.
Motorola Mobility clearly made its name in the gadget world, but due to some problems encountered, it went down the hill. From there, here comes Google announcing an agreement to acquire Motorola for $12.5 million.
Google and Motorola Mobility together will accelerate innovation and consumers will get better phones at lower prices.
Motorola Mobility patent portfolio helps protect the Android ecosystem that is vital to competition in the mobile device space.
And exclusive here in our studio via video call, we have invited an expert in this matter to give us insights on how did Motorola responded to competition with other brands. So let us talk about first, how was the Google-Motorola relationship back then?
Actually, it was a good start for both of the companies. However, aside from Motorola's enormous probe of patents, which Google explicitly said at that time, that will be used to protect Android handset makers from being sued by Apple and Microsoft. The only reason for Google to buy Motorola was to transform it into healthy counterweight to Samsung,
which sells the overwhelming majority of Android smartphones.
Yeah, that is correct. So the bottom line is Google retained the rights to Motorola's patents, but licensed them to Lenovo.
But was it a mutual decision for Google and Motorola to sell Motorola to Lenovo?
Yes, it was a mutual decision that Google sold Motorola's mobile phone operation to Lenovo. Well, obviously, this was a good move for Google and good move for Lenovo, although it may not be a good move for consumers.
All right, thank you so much for your time and letting us have a very short interview with you, sir. On the other hand, our team tried to contact Google to ask for their statement on why a sale took place for Motorola. And here is the released official statement.
Good day to our consumers. I would just like to give light on the news about the Google sale of Motorola when it actually brings benefits to both companies. So first, Google's mobile strategy is to get Android onto as many phones as possible, as almost all of the company's revenue come from advertising, including on mobile devices. Secondly, Google wanted Motorola for the patents, not for the manufacturing. You know, Apple patent attack that worries Google's consumers. Motorola had a massive patent library that can be used defensively. Honestly, Motorola never made Google any money. By giving up Motorola, we Google can be neutral, honest broker of operating systems to the world and to make money doing so.
Lenovo's US market share is zero, still pursued to buy Motorola. We have in Zoom conference the executive director of Lenovo, Ms. Pat. Good morning, Ms. Pat. So people around the world are so attached about Lenovo buying Motorola from Google, rather. What specifically are the reasons why did Lenovo continue with this transaction?
Motorola has an 85 years history in the US, and at this point, getting into the US market is all about the relationship with the US carriers. Motorola relationships are really, really good. We believe that Motorola is the key to get into US.
But it is right that Lenovo's biggest business is focused on PCs or computers, and yet you just have recently purchased Motorola Mobility.
Our company's biggest business is still PCs, which we were the number one maker, but sales aren't growing. If Lenovo is going to be a technology leader in 2010s, it needs to be a mobile tech leader. Assembling a global smartphone business is key.
Alright, so I guess that would be all, Ms. Pat. Thank you so much. I hope people around the world get to watch this online exclusive interview with Lenovo. And now, live in Motorola Mobility main office, we have Denise. May we know if there was any internal conflict that caused Motorola to its failure?
Yes, Gly, we have interviewed one of the Motorola's managers and he said that Motorola was in its watershed in its history. Bob Galvin, the CEO of Motorola, also recognized that his legacy was in jeopardy and that it needed change, and he felt compelled to carry out his vision before retiring. He was banking on strength and growth to compete and build the Motorola brand. However, with growth comes in growing pains, delays in production and development were caused by conflict between management layers. The manager also admitted that there was little control and discipline happening inside the Motorola company. The corporation's many layers of management were a liability to the company itself. Managers are also misinformed about the most recent business development or strategies and choose inappropriate actions in their strategic adjustments.
Thank you, Denise. And now, Let's go on to our next segment of Did You Know with DYK.
Thank you, Ms. Liza, and welcome back to our segment of Did You Know with DYK. So for today's video, we're going to talk about Did You Know that Motorola has a lot of competitors, and some of these competitors have outgrown them and caused their failure. But before we talk about their failures, let's take a look at who are these competitors and what are their strategies to success. Let's go!
One of the competitors of Motorola is, of course, Apple. We all know Apple, right? The first strategy that the Apple used is to focus on design and functionality of products. Since most of their buyers are millennials and Gen Z, of course, they must focus on the outlook and most importantly, including all those advanced features and capabilities of its product and services. Second, enhancing customer experience. Focusing on customer experience, wow, look at those stunning photos, only on Apple. Lastly, decreasing dependence of the business on the sales of iPhones. They say no to more sales but poor quality, and yes to high quality to produce more sales. Next up, Samsung. In 1996, as its strategy, Samsung changed its perspective from competing in price to competing in technology. They're not using only cell phone, but also digital appliances. Second, they prioritized their innovations by patent. Good job, Samsung, on studying lawsuits and country laws.
No.
Lastly, they scattered research and development team across the globe so that consumers' references can be reflected in their product innovation. Wow, very good strategy, Samsung. Last but not the least competitor of Motorola is Lenovo. Lenovo called its strategy as 3S, covering smart Internet of Things, smart infrastructure, and smart verticals. This service-led transformation will ensure Lenovo can meet the needs of individual workers and students as well as large organizations as they utilize and depend on technology more and more. Wow, brilliant! And this one is special because to fast forward, Lenovo acquired Motorola company later on.
And that's all for today's video. I hope you gained something new information. And see you on our next segment of Did You Know with DYK. Bye-bye! Back to you, Liza.
Thank you for that entertaining and informative video, Ms. DYK. We will be right back.
Back to the number one noontime show in the Philippines, Family Feud! Ngayon naman, nasa last segment na tayo ng game show, Team 1 ang maglalaro. Sila Ann Curtis, Liza Soberano, at Kathryn Bernardo. Woo!
Okay. With this.
Ready na ba kayo, Team 1?
Yeah. Ready na! Ready, ready!
Mukhang ang energetic, ha? Okay, napakadali lang ng ating game. Ang sagot sa mga tanong ay batay sa survey ng 100 businessman. Kapag nakuha nyo lahat ng sagot na nakalagay sa screen, ay maaari kayong mag-uwi ng nagtataginting o tumataginting na 200,000 pesos! Pero, kapag kayo ay nagkamali ng 3 beses, ay hindi nyo makukuha ang 200,000 pesos, pero mag-uwi naman kayo ng 50,000 pesos. Not bad, di ba, guys?
Kaya to, guys. Kaya.
Kaya alamin na natin kung anong sabi ng survey. Nag-survey kami ng 100 businessman and the top 4 answer are on the board. What should have been done to avoid business failure?
Oh my gosh! Curtis,
ano sa tingin mo ang sagot?
Siyempre, huwag mangutang ng mangutang.
Tama yan! Meron yan! Huwag mangutang ng mangutang. Ang sabi naman ng survey ay... falling into debt. Ano na ba? Ann Curtis, nakuha ng sagot natin, top answer pa. Mag-proceed naman tayo kay Kathryn Bernardo. What should have been done to avoid business failure?
Siyempre, dapat maganda yung strategy nila, di ba? Good strategy!
Tama, tama! Yeah. Meron yan!
Good strategy. Tingnan naman natin ang survey kung nag-agree sa'yo. Ang survey ay... Woo! Grabe, pasok pa din at sunod-sunod pa. Pwede. Dalawang tamang sagot na lang ay maaari nyo nang maiuwi ang 200,000 pesos!
Yay!
Liza Soberano, ikaw naman. What should have been done to avoid business failure?
Ito para sa lahat, be optimistic.
Wala.
Meron yan, meron.
Be optimistic, ha? Ang sabi naman ng survey ay...
Okay lang yan, isa pa lang yan.
Ikaw naman ulit, Ann Curtis, what should have been done to avoid business failure?
Siguro i-monitor yung cash flow.
I-monitor ang cash flow.
Pwede.
Tingnan natin.
Pwede.
Sabi ng survey ay? Grabe naman.
Sana lang.
Third answer. Pag nakuha ni Kathryn Bernardo ang sunod na tamang sagot, ay po pwede nyo na maiuwi ang pot money na 200,000 pesos. Kathryn Bernardo, ito yung chance mo. Okay. What should have been done to avoid business failure?
No cut!
OMG.
No cut!
Siyempre, kailangan yung service mo sa customers. Pwede yun, di ba?
Pwede.
Tama.
Service sa customer. Ano naman ang sabi ng survey?
Yo!
Nakuha niyo lahat ng sagot sa ating scoreboard at maiuwi niyo na ang 200,000 pesos! Sino mga gustong pasalamatan o i-shout out? Ann Curtis?
Si Jericho Rosales kung may gustong i-shout out.
Ah, si Jericho. Sige nga, pagbigyan natin sila. Mr. Jericho Rosales, baka may gusto kang i-shout out dyan.
Siyempre naman, meron akong gustong i-shout out. Shout out nga pala kay Sir Neil Halcon, prof namin sa Astrabus. Bigyan niyo naman kami ng una, sir.
Pwede.
Ano naman yun? Baka naman pwede pong pagbigyan, Sir Halcon, ng mga estudyante mo ng plot 1. At dito nagtatapos ang number 1 family game show ng Pilipinas.
Family Feud!